I'm Dr. Eric Sandler, Director of Audiology at the Hearing Center in New Jersey. We are a multi-location private practice. We've been working with cochlear implant recipients and candidates for about 2.5 years at this point. We wanted to be more than just the place people went for hearing aids. We wanted to be the type of practice where any audiological needs could be met. And when we had a patient who was a cochlear implant candidate, we didn't want to have to refer them elsewhere.
It's been unbelievably rich, enriching. I've people telling me that they hear their family members for the first time, the interactions and the social situations that they're able to be in, things that they realize they're missing.
Having a practice that offers all aspects of audiology really is a way to establish yourself as the expert. It's a way to differentiate yourself from others out in the marketplace. And it's a way to really make your practice more attractive to the best and the brightest coming up in the field. So for me, it's a long game decision to be incorporating this into our practice. As an audiologist working with cochlear implants, we do have the opportunity to work with patients who are bimodal. And for those bimodal patients, oftentimes that does translate at some point to a new hearing aid for them.
Bimodal hearing is a use of a cochlear implant on one side and a hearing aid on the other.
Maybe out there, the idea of working with cochlear implants is a little bit intimidating. After we had the conversations with Cochlear, it really just seemed like something that could smoothly integrate into what we were already doing. We have a very good relationship with Dr. McAfee. He's the surgeon who we generally refer to when it comes to CI surgery.
I would encourage an audiology practice who's not currently working with CI to consider doing so. And the reason is this. Patients are going to continue to progress in their hearing pathology to a point at which they need that implant. If practices are well-versed with cochlear implantation and becoming more knowledgeable in that regard is only going to allow them to retain their patients and build their practices.
When a surgeon refers a patient to you for a cochlear implant evaluation, I think in some ways they're recognizing that you're doing work other audiologists aren't. When Dr. McAfee sends a patient our way for a cochlear implant evaluation, he knows that we've assisted in getting his surgical patients excellent outcomes with their cochlear implants when it comes to their follow-up appointments and their mappings. So I think that's really strengthened the relationship and strengthened his confidence in us as a place where he can be comfortable sending his CI recipients. From our perspective, Cochlear has been there really every step of the way to support us with what we need, whether it's outreach, whether it's billing questions, whether it's additional training. They've made themselves available to us, and it's allowed us to be successful in the way we work with our patients.
Cochlear Provider Network has helped me to build those relationships, and the trust that's come from those relationships has built my own practice, and that's allowed me to provide better care for the people in our community.
You fit somebody with hearing aids, you improve their life, the appointment ends with a handshake. Patients who get cochlear implants, those appointments, they end in a hug.